In today's video, I'll take you to a nuclear plant hidden in a mountain. Rumor had it that China built an underground Great Wall for nuclear purpose. I don't know anything about that, but there really was a nuclear plant in the mountain. Today, I'll take you for a tour. Last time I checked, it was only open to Chinese citizens, so most of you can only see it through my camera.
To explore a nuclear plant. It's hidden in this mountain behind me. And do you notice the 816 code above the entrance? It's the name of this plant.
Taking a bus from Fuling along the beautiful Wujiang River, we came to a small town named Baitao. 40 years ago, a top secret was hidden in the mountain here. The mountain was excavated and a nuclear military plant was built inside. The project was under construction for 17 years, the same as the Three Gorges Dam. It started in 1966. The day the project was approved, the small town was wiped out from the map. 60,000 soldiers and engineers came here. But even the local people didn't have any clue of what's going on here. Only a long chimney was standing in the mountain.
Before we go, there's one thing I want to clarify. This project was cancelled in 1984 when it was 80% finished. It was never in use, so there's no radiation inside.
The plant mostly preserved its original condition. When it was made a tourism spot, only two changes were made: the floor and the lighting. In this tunnel, a section of the original floor was preserved. This is the before, and right next to it is the after. Lights were added to light up the space, otherwise it would be like this. This is the map of the project, which is like a maze. The project is the largest man-made tunnel structure in the world. There are 18 caverns linked by over 130 tunnels of different sizes. The total distance of the tunnels in this project is more than 20 kilometers. Only a small portion of the project is open to tourists. Mostly the reactor and the associated infrastructure under the code 101. We'll start our tour and go inside the project through this tunnel. All tourists would take a card at the gate to go inside. The tunnel is about 400 meters long. Let's time it. People from two carts would be grouped and assigned a presenter. It's not allowed to go solo because it's very easy to get lost inside. The first room we saw was a power plant. The main reactor of the 816 project is a dual-purpose reactor. It was used to produce nuclear fuel, and the residual heat was used to generate power. There were supposed to be two 800,000 kilowatt turbine generators installed here. The generators had already been shipped here, but the project was cut off. Otherwise, it would have been the first nuclear power plant in China using residual nuclear heat. The lights on the wall were simulating how the power generators would work. In the corner of this room, there is a real-size prototype of atomic bomb. The product of A-16 nuclear plant was supposed to be plutonium-239, a nuclear fuel used to make atomic bomb. I've never imagined an atomic bomb would be so small. I thought it would be huge. The next stop is a diversion tunnel. A section of the tunnel was decorated with lights and we could walk through it. In the diversion tunnel, there is a pipe that would have drawn water from Wujiang River that we saw earlier in the video to cool the reactor. The total distance of this diversion tunnel is 3 kilometers. The cavern 101 is where the reactor system is located and is the largest cavern of the 816 project. The complex within cavern 101 consists of 12 floors. On the third floor is the bottom of the reactor. A glass bridge was built so tourists could stand above the so-called pot. Green lights were installed to simulate reactions that would have been happening in this room. Above the bridge is the core reactor in which there are 2001 rods. Each would have been loaded with 64 pieces of natural uranium fuel elements and 60 aluminum cushions. This is the place that would have had maximum radiation. There is a small door from where we exit the room. It's an emergency door. Then we went to different floors via the stairs. Each floor has its own function, but most of them were not open. The top of the reactor is on the 8th floor. There is even an elevator in this complex, but it's not functioning now. This is the top of the reactor. It's the other end of the 2001 rods we saw on the 3rd floor. Green lights were added to the rods so we could see them better. The reactor used graphite water cooling thermal neutron technique. I was reading the description on the wall. Sounds very fancy. My understanding is, whatever fancy process it takes, natural uranium in, plutonium-239 out. One floor above, on the 9th floor, is the controlling center. It's the brain of the reactor. There are 2001 buttons within the round shapes on the wall, each connected to a rod. This room was equipped with the most advanced computer system in China. Scientists working here were graduates from top Chinese universities. On the 7th floor, there is a room with monitoring instruments. The majority instruments in this room are electronic potentiometer. They were supposed to be used to measure the flow of the rods. Taking a close look, it's been more than 40 years and they still look very new. It's very moist in the cavern and there's no rust inside the instrument. One reason is, of course, the instruments were of high quality. They were manufactured in Shanghai at the end of 1970s. Another reason is the paint on the wall. It used a special material that could absorb moist. This dark space was the exhaust center of the reactor. It's linked to the chimney, the only thing that could be seen from outside. The chimney is 151 meters above the ground with a diameter of 4 meters. The space below this glass floor was the storage center for uranium elements. It's 12.5 meters deep and covers an area of 66 meters times 12 meters. On the walls of the plant, there are lots of slogans written by the constructors to encourage themselves. On this wall, it says, "The foolish old man removes the mountains." It is a well-known Chinese fable that first appeared in the 4th century BC. It is about a foolish old man of 90 years who lived near a pair of mountains. Annoyed by the obstruction caused by the mountains, he sought to dig through them with hoes and baskets. The fable was passed on generation by generation in China over thousands of years. It tells about the virtues of perseverance and willpower that Chinese people value. Some background of why this plant was built and why the project was cancelled. The 816 project was part of the Third Front movement starting in 1964. Beginning in 1963, the worsening Sino-Soviet political relation and growing military presence of the United States in Vietnam bothered the Chinese chairman Mao Zedong. As the United States expanded its role in the Vietnam War, Chairman Mao feared the conflict could spread to China and result in a nuclear attack. China's industrial bases were concentrated on northeastern China and the eastern coast, which was under the attacking range of Soviet Union and U.S. aircraft carriers, respectively. Destruction of these infrastructures could lead to disastrous consequences. Chairman Mao and his generals envisaged three lines of defense, coastal, central, and western, and they decided in 1964 on a massive construction of military industrial complexes in western China, the third line of defense. The purpose of the Third Front Movement was to establish a complete industrial system in China's interior parts. Third Front projects follow the principle, close to the mountains, dispersed and hidden. The 816 project is a good example. The plant is 400 meters away from the edge of the mountain, as we've seen in the beginning when we traveled through the long tunnel. The top of the project is 200 meters away from top of the mountain. It's completely hidden in the mountain. The project could stand hydrogen bomb and earthquakes up to M8. In 1970s, geopolitical environment changed. Due to the Cold War between the US and Soviet Union, and due to the mentality of the enemy of my enemy is my friend, US approached China. In 1972, Nixon visited China. In 1979, China and the US established diplomatic relations.
The United States of America and the People's Republic of China have agreed to recognize each other and to establish diplomatic relations as of January the 1st, 1979.
The Chinese President Deng Xiaoping envisioned a long period of peaceful environment and believed it's a good window for economic development. Therefore, the Third Front Movement and projects like 816 that required large investment and resources were cut off. In 1984, the 816 project was officially cancelled. This is the end of the tour. In the exit tunnel, there is an exhibition of belongings from soldiers and engineers who participated in this project. In next week's video, I'll take you to an underwater museum. It's not a museum to observe fish, but to observe a stone ridge with continuous hydrological inscriptions of the Yangtze River for over 1,200 years. Why is the stone under the water now? What are the inscriptions on the stone? You'll find the answer in next week's video. I'm Yan Yan. I upload a video every Saturday about sites of interest in China and histories and stories behind them. Subscribe to my channel. I'll see you next week at the White Crane Ridge Underwater Museum.